Ironized Yeast presents Lights Out, Everybody. Lights Out brings you stories of the supernatural and the supernormal, dramatizing the fantasies and the mysteries of the unknown. We tell you this frankly, so if you wish to avoid the excitement and tension of these imaginative plays, we urge you calmly but sincerely to turn off your radio now.
This is Arch Obler. Tonight, a strange story about ordinary people. Two girls just like you or your daughter or the girl who works next to you in the office.
And now, Lights Out, Everybody.
Alice. You think we're still in the United States?
I'm beginning to doubt it.
Are you sure you got the right address?
Of course.
Well, don't be so dogmatic. You have made mistakes.
Sounds as if you're starting to get annoyed.
Well, I am. We've been driving so long, my back feels as if somebody were doing a big apple on it.
Oh, we'll be there soon enough.
You know, Alice, sometimes that calm nature of yours makes me good and tired.
You sound as if you want to quarrel.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just that, I looked forward to this vacation for weeks, and now that it's happening, it isn't so much fun.
Oh, wait till you get to my Aunt Harriet's. You can curl up in the alfalfa and sleep for days.
Sleep. Oh, that's a lovely word. Just imagine, sleeping as long as you want without having to worry about making an 8 o'clock class. Oh,
perfect.
But are you sure you know where your Aunt Harriet lives?
I've run out of synonyms for her. Of course I do.
Oh, I just like to reassure myself. I certainly hope she has soft beds.
Oh, and that reminds me, you did send her that letter that we're coming.
No.
Say that again?
No, I didn't send the letter.
You mean to say that she doesn't even know that we're coming to stay with her?
Well, I decided it'd be more fun if we sort of surprised her.
Well, of all the brainstorms, walking in on somebody you haven't seen for 10 years and expecting her to welcome you.
She's my only aunt, isn't she?
But maybe she won't have room for
us. Don't be silly. I told you Aunt Harriet lives alone and likes it.
Well, maybe she won't like it if we barge in on her.
Don't be silly. Of course we'll be welcome. From what I've heard, she's a little old darling.
When you were 8, she was a darling. For all you know, she's taken the welcome mat in years ago.
Oh.
Wait a minute. Didn't you say we were supposed to go down Camden Road 3 miles?
Yes.
Then you are lost. That sign back there, this isn't Camden Road.
You're silly.
I saw it with my own eyes. It said Pig Snackle Road.
Oh,
there, see that? Pig Snackle Road. You are wrong.
Pig Snackle Road. That's too good to be true.
Are you crazy, laughing at a name of a place when you haven't got any idea where you are and my
back? Oh, don't be silly. I'm sure we'll find... Hey, there. There it is.
There's what? The edge of the world?
Oh, no, the crossroad. The entrance to Aunt Harriet's place ought to be just a little bit beyond it.
That's what you say.
Well, yes. There it is. Here, we turn here. Turn.
Hey, wait a minute. What are you trying to do, turn over?
Oh, it won't be long now.
You're telling me. This is no road. It's a cow pad.
Yeah. Aunt Harriet likes privacy.
Oh.
I remember Dad and Mother used to say that.
Another 100 feet on this road, and I won't need a bed. I'll need a stretcher. Come on, slow down. I knew it. What a road. Even the tires couldn't take it.
What do we care? Aunt Harriet's place just a little ways down. We'll walk.
You mean leave the car right here in the middle of the road?
It's Aunt Harriet's own private road. No one will bother it. Oh, come on. Take your bag. Let's get out of here.
Oh, all right. I'm just a stooge.
Come on, let's go. We'll just be in time for dinner.
That's what you think.
What do you mean?
I mean, maybe your Aunt Harriet doesn't like guests who walk in just like that. Hey, Alice, now what are you stopping for?
Well, I just noticed.
Noticed what?
How dark it's getting.
So what? Come on. When the sun starts setting, it gets dark. I learned that in Physical Science 101.
Yeah, but back there on the road, it was so light, and here it's so dark and gloomy.
What's the matter with you? Are you going to take your suitcase and come on, or are you going to stand there being afraid of the dark?
I'm all right.
So many trees around here, no wonder it's dark. If that Aunt Harriet of yours wants privacy, she sure got it. And I hope when we get there, I'll have the same...
Lona.
Now what?
Look at that mist coming up through the trees.
Yeah.
Like
Long, white, curling fingers.
Oh, stop that, will you? It's just that it's getting late. Colder, moisture's condensing. Oh, will we ever get there, riding and walking? Have you actually got an Aunt Harriet? Come on, let's go
back. Hey, wait, Lona, there it is.
Huh? Hallelujah, it is a house. Well, it's about time. It's about time. Harder, Alice. Knock harder.
I can't. It hurts my knuckle.
Oh, let me.
She must be home. There's a light upstairs.
And you were going to surprise her, eh?
But she never leaves this place.
Oh, go on. You don't even know that she lives here. Fine business. Car with a flat stuck in the middle of nowhere. Nobody home in this godforsaken place. Me so tired I could sleep standing on my head.
But she must be home.
You're repeating yourself. Oh, if this is a vacation.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait. Wait, there's someone at the door.
Oh, yes. Yes? Oh, what do you want?
I'm looking for... are you Miss Saugus?
Yes, yes. Oh, what do you want?
Well, then you are Aunt Harriet.
Hallelujah again.
Who's calling me Aunt Harriet? Who, I say? Who are you?
Why, I'm Alice Preston.
Alice? Oh, yes, yes. Bless my soul. I know you. Come in. Come in.
Hallelujah, we're here.
Come in. Come in. Close the door.
Oh, Aunt Harriet, you don't know how glad I am to see you. Did we have a time getting here?
Yes. Come right in here. Right in here.
There, Lona. I told you we'd be welcome.
She didn't even ask who I was.
Now, put your things down here and sit down and make yourself comfortable.
Thanks. Aunt Harriet, this is my girlfriend, Lona Stevens. We roomed together at the university, and I asked her to come along with me.
It's all right, my child. It's all right. Anyone's welcome. Anyone at all.
Oh, that's very kind of you, Aunt Harriet. I hope you won't mind my calling you that, but Alice always...
There, my child. It's all right. A name's a name. Now, sit here and be comfortable. I'll get some tea.
Oh, no, really, Aunt Harriet.
Well, apparently your Aunt Harriet does what she wants to do.
Doesn't she?
Oh, well, as long as we're here. Hmm. Like something out of a museum, isn't it?
What?
A house, the furnishings. Look at the chairs and that sofa. Are they prehistoric or are they prehistoric?
Yeah, I didn't think she was so old.
Oh, you mean your aunt?
Yes.
Oh, well, after all, in 10 years, living alone out in this godforsaken place, I sort of think she's nice.
Do you?
Taking us right in and not asking us all sorts of silly questions. That's the kind of relative to have. You know, if I were to go barging in on any of mine, first they'd give me a third degree on how come I was away from school, and then they'd give me another third degree on how long I was going to stay.
Lona.
What's the matter?
Back there in the shadows.
What is
it? I don't... It's something moving.
Why, it's a dog.
Oh?
Why, no, it's a cat.
Cat? It is a cat.
Not a cat. Look at the size of it. Tiger.
Lona, what'll we do?
Don't move. If we do, it'll...
Now, here's your tea, young lady. Nice, warm tea. Just what you need.
Aunt Harriet.
What's the matter? What? Oh, he's frightened you.
What? What is it?
You've got eyes, haven't you?
Well, yes, but
it's so dark in that corner, we can't hardly tell. It's not a tiger, is it?
Don't talk nonsense.
Well, what is it?
He shouldn't be here at all. It's much too early for him.
Aunt Harriet, didn't you hear me? I asked you what it is.
Oh, what do you think he is?
Well, it
can't be a cat.
Why, he's as big as a police
dog. All right, come upstairs. I'll show you to your room. Now, this way, I'll show you.
Aunt Harriet, I don't...
Come along. I say, now, come along up these stairs.
Come on, Alice.
Why, don't
come
you?
On, we better do as she says.
All right.
You must be tired, you two.
But Aunt Harriet, how could it be a cat when we...
Talk no more about it. Talk no more about it now. We'll talk about that tomorrow morning. In here, my dears. In here.
Come on, Ellen. But why doesn't she answer me?
There, you see. A very comfortable room for both of you to rest in. Nice wide bed. Everything clean.
But, Aunt Harriet,
nice
wait just a minute.
Yes.
I want to find out something about
this.
Forget it, Alice.
Whatever it is, you can find out in the morning.
But that cat...
Oh, cat. Can't you say anything but cat?
It was so huge.
Huge nothing. Well, we just imagined it, that's all. I mean, there in the shadows, it looked monstrous. You heard it. It sounded just like an ordinary tomcat.
But I
You
thought
didn't see it... any more than I saw, and I think it was just a long shadow that got us fooled, that's all.
Yes, that could be it. Couldn't it?
Of course. You remember in Psych 101 class, old Pudgy Wudgy told us about the tricks your eyes play in bad light when it comes to judging signs.
Yeah, I remember. Local signs, they call them.
Right. Well, that's the way it was with that cat. I'll bet you your Aunt Harriet thinks we're both a little screwy. That's why she got us up here to bed in a hurry. Oh, bed. Isn't that a wonderful word? And will we sleep?
I hope so.
Alice.
What?
You're not sleeping either, are you?
No, I am. I wanted to talk to you for hours, but I wasn't sure.
I thought you were asleep.
Somehow, I can't.
Me neither.
I can't understand why.
I'm the one who was crying how tired I was.
The bed's so comfortable.
The house is quiet enough.
The house?
Huh?
Maybe that's why we can't sleep.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, there's something about the house.
What?
Something... impressive that won't let us sleep.
Oh, you're crazy.
No, I'm not.
It's just that we're too tired to sleep, that's all. Yes, that's it. Too tired, nerves on edge.
Well, I've been lying here for hours trying to figure it out. Now I know.
Will you stop talking like that?
Don't you feel it, Lona? Don't you?
Well, I...
Tell the truth, you do feel it. It's something heavy in the air, you know, pressing down on us. I'm awfully frightened, Lona. Awful.
Well, you're not going to frighten me. Why, this is your own Aunt Harriet's house. She's down there sleeping, and she...
Meow.
Oh.
Meow.
That cat.
Yeah.
It sounds huge, doesn't it?
That's because it's so quiet in the house.
Lona, there's another one. I tell you, there's two of them. Lona, listen to them. They're not ordinary cats. Listen to them.
And now back to our lights out story of Little Old Lady.
I'll call Aunt Harriet. She'll tell me. She'll make them stop.
Alice, wait. Don't go out there, you little fool.
Aunt Harriet, I've got
to... Get away from that door. Listen to those things down there. Listen to them.
No. No, I can't stand any more of it. Aunt Harriet. Aunt Harriet, make them stop. Aunt Harriet! They've gone.
What?
What were they?
Could two cats make all that noise?
Aunt Harriet, why don't you come in here?
No, Alice, don't open that door.
Oh, but Aunt Harriet, why doesn't she answer me? She must know what it's all about. Why doesn't she?
Wait!
What?
Listen.
Someone's coming up the stairs.
Yes.
My Aunt Harriet?
It's not quite like footsteps.
The cat.
Maybe...
The door.
Cats can't open doors.
It's right outside the door.
I can hear, can't I?
Is it a cat?
Of course it is.
You don't think so either, do you?
It's just sitting there.
Yes.
Let it sit there.
I'm so afraid.
When morning comes, we'll get out of here.
Aunt Harriet. Aunt Harriet, why don't you answer me?
Oh, stop that.
There's something outside of our door, Aunt Harriet. We don't know
what it is.
What's the use of calling if she won't answer you?
Why do you say that?
Because she hasn't answered us and she won't.
But she's in the house. She must know.
Wait.
Trying to get in.
As long as the door is shut.
We're safe enough.
Aunt Harriet! Oh, please wake up, Aunt Harriet.
No!
What?
Look. Doorknob. It's turning.
Oh.
Alice. Can't open doors.
You mean Aunt Harriet?
Yes.
Yes, it must be Aunt Harriet.
She will, and she's trying to open the door. I'll open it for her.
No. Oh, no, Lona, stay away from that door. I'm afraid. Oh, don't.
Come right in, Aunt Harriet. No!
I've got to get help. I've got to. Oh, my arm. I can't stand pain. I've got to. Wood's so thick. I'm lost. And I've got to get help. Someone's got to help me. I'll get help for you. I'll get help. It's getting bright. It's dawn. If I could only find a path, a road. She's tearing my clothes. Why do you tear my clothes? I just want to get help for Lona. I'll get help for you, Lona. I will. Road.
An automobile. Help. Help. Stop. You've got to stop. Help me. Please. Oh, help me. Oh, Lona.
Where is sister? What's the matter?
Oh,
who are you?
Help me. Come with me right now.
Now,
please
take it easy. Talk. Take it easy. I'll help
hurry.
You. Sure, I'll help
you.
You
must help me.
I'm sheriff of this county.
Hurry, you must help me.
Now, wait a minute.
Please.
Are you with the girls who left that car on the side road back in the woods?
Car, yes. Yes, we left our car there.
Oh.
Oh, hurry. Please help me. My friend, Lona.
Joe! These
oh,
are the
no,
girls.
Talk,
we found your car in the woods,
no.
And we've been looking for you for hours.
Please don't stand there talking. Hurry. We've got to help her. It's killing her.
Killing her? Joe, did you hear what she said?
Don't talk. Hurry. Hurry and come with me. Please hurry. I beg of you.
All right. Now take it easy, sister. This is the house, ain't it?
Yes. Oh, yes. This is the place.
The old service house. Yeah. Try the door, Joe.
Hurry.
It's open, Sheriff.
Push it.
Well, let's go.
She's upstairs. She's upstairs.
Nobody down here, Sheriff.
Right here.
All right. Let's get up there.
Here.
I don't know what this is all about, but I'm soon going to find out.
Lona, we're coming for you. Lona, we're coming.
Right. Hey. What room is it, Sheriff?
Right here, that room. That room right there. Hurry. It's killing her.
Get your gun out, Joe.
Please.
Door is partly open.
Well,
okay, kick
in.
It open.
Please.
Watch yourself. Careful, Joe.
Sheriff!
Sister, you stay here.
Lona.
Sheriff, there's nobody in this room.
Lona.
Huh? Look for yourself.
Please.
Well, now what?
Lona.
The...
Lona, where are you?
Now, wait a minute, sister. Are you sure that the...
Yes, she was here. Right here. It came in the door. Jumped at her. I turned. I ran. I jumped out of the window.
Hey, this window ain't broke.
But I tell you, I went through it. See? See, my arm.
Yeah. But there's no one in here.
Oh,
the bed, why, it ain't even messed up.
Oh,
did you say you two were sleeping, sister?
We were. Oh, no. Where are you? What has it done with you?
Aunt Harriet.
Huh?
She'll know. Or has it killed her, too?
Sheriff, come quick! Come quick! Bring the girl!
Oh, come along, sister.
Joe, what is it? Look in there.
Aunt Harriet.
Old lady sitting in the rocker and knitting.
Oh, Aunt Harriet. Lona, where is she? What happened? Oh, Aunt Harriet, please tell me.
Yeah, tell us all.
Might I ask what this is all about?
Aunt Harriet, what's the matter? Didn't you hear anything? Lona, that horrible cat thing. What did it do to her? Answer me, what did it do?
Would you gentlemen tell me who is this hysterical young girl?
Aunt Harriet.
Now, look here. Don't you know who this girl is?
I certainly do not.
But, Aunt Harriet, I'm Alice. I came here with Lona. Don't you remember?
You must be mistaken. I've been alone all night.
You hear that,
no.
Joe?
No, I was here. Lona and I did come here. It's a horrible joke. That's what it is. Aunt Harriet, please. Please tell him you're just joking. Lona, where is she?
I don't know what you're talking about. I never saw you before in all my life.
No. Oh, no, that's not true, Aunt Harriet. Aunt Harriet.
Now, wait a minute. I've had about enough of this out of you, sister. Chasing up here with all that bunkum about cats and killings and all that.
No. Yeah. Everything. You
better come along with us.
Everything I said to you was true. It was true.
Joe, take her other arm.
No, let go of me.
Come on now.
Oh, please,
don't
Aunt Harriet,
raise a fuss.
Don't let them take me away.
Come on, sister.
Horrible cat things. I tell you, there were two of them here.
Oh, come on.
Oh, don't let them take me
away. Now, don't mind her, old lady. We'll take care of her.
Yes. Take good care of her. Cracked little thing.
Now, come on, sister.
No. Wait. Look at her teeth as she laughs. Look at her teeth.
Mother in heaven, they're cat's teeth.
And the hands, they're claws.
No. Stay away from me.
Grab her, Joe.
Stop you.
Let me go.
Stop my hand.
Get her, Joe.
She's in the
way. Joe. Dead. Oh, Aunt Harriet.
Oh, she's no aunt of anything human. I can tell you that. Look at her.
But my Aunt Harriet. Aunt Harriet Saugus.
Saugus? You hear that, Sheriff?
Yeah. So you came here thinking she was Mrs. Saugus. Did you, girl?
Yes. Yes, Lona and I. And Lona must be dead now. How could my aunt do what she did? How could she?
This thing is no aunt of yours, child. Your Aunt Harriet Saugus died in this house 3 years ago. And she left two cats.
My dear Mr. Obler.
Oh, come, Frank. Don't tell me you don't believe tonight's story.
Should I?
Frank, did you ever hear of lycanthropy?
The who?
The cancer. I was looking it up just then. That's why I didn't answer you. It's a form of illusion in which the person imagined he's a wolf.
Oh, yeah. Main Street's full of them.
Seriously. Only a handful of years ago, it was the firm belief of many people that certain human beings could turn into animals.
Now, Mr. Obler, what about those wolves? Do you think that people can turn into wolves and cats?
And poor fish? No. But under certain provocations, the human mind can certainly transform itself into many peculiar forms. Even we who are normal. Haven't we met women who are catty, men who are brave as lions, and others who made you wonder whether they were men or mice? Now, Frank, let's talk about next week's story. Next week, just an experiment, entirely different type of lights-out story. An entirely different approach. There's love and a boy and a girl in it. Now, it's a story I did a very long time ago to a rather limited audience. And I know that you, 13 millions who listen to Lights Out, will enjoy The Ugliest Man in the World, next week.
Yes, tune in next Tuesday again for Arch Obler's eerie story, The Ugliest Man in the World.
This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.